Welcome to Dhaksh tutorials related to Django. In the previous session, we have seen how to create a website project using Django and create an application in that. And we have seen that using only of the editing the pages only app only using Python. But today I am going to show you how to create an HTML, means how to use HTML pages in Django and that to display in our website using Django. And if you are liking my sessions, please do subscribe to my channel, YouTube channel, that is Dhaksh Tutorial Konga. And please do comment me for more informative, to go me more interactive. Okay, now let's start the session. So the previous session, we have seen how everything using Visual Studio Code. But today I will show you how to do something without, if you don't have any separate IDE, but how to do that. So before going to that, I'll be opening to our web folder, going to the location where my folder is created. So it's in desktop, Dhaksh, and in that again, I have to go to that Dhaksh site. Okay. So now I will be creating another application because I have already told you in this project you can have n number of applications, apps. So previously we have seen web app, and today I am going to create some personal app by name personal app. So how to create an app? So write down python manage.py start app personal app created. So now go to your folder and just check it out. In Dhaksh site, you could see personal app. The same files which are all there in your things. So now first what you will be doing, we have to create the HTML page. To create HTML page, you have to write. So okay, before that, I will be telling you one thing in which is some settings.py which will be there in your root directory, that is root folder. So go and edit anything you want to edit. You can just click here, edit with IDLE of Python, and you will get this edit file of your Python. And then here you could see, this is the page where you could see you set all your like database settings, anything like change your database. By default, your database will be SQLite. But if you want to change that to Oracle or anything, you can install that in your system, and you can write here the path and give the name of the particular database. Alright, and now if these are the install applications, by default your Django has these applications like admin, or the admin is for administration purpose, and AUTH is for authorization. Content types, whatever the content types are there, and used sessions, messages, static files and all. So here you can install. Previously we did not use this setting. Even that, if you don't use also, you will get this. But as we are using today HTML files, we need to do this particular thing. So whatever the application you create, you start, the same application name should be written here in your installed apps, that is personal app, whatever the same thing personal app I have written and set with comma. And this is the thing of finishes your settings.py, and you have nothing more to do here. And now in your personal app, whenever you are creating any HTML pages or any other thing, you have to create, because all these files will be residing in a place called templates in Django. So you create a file name by folder name by templates, and in the templates you have to create another folder with your application name, whatever the application name you write. You start your application, you give your application as personal app, so that personal app folder should be there in your templates. Because in Django, all HTML files created will be all residing at one place. So if you write, if you have a same file name, like you are using many applications and you are using same application like home.html or index.html file in various applications. So what happens there where they are residing originally in your Django, there will be a confusion. The ambiguity arises when you call any one particular HTML file. So to avoid that concept or that ambiguity, better write in template, write down and take another folder as a personal app, and in that you write down the HTML files. So that whenever you call index file or any HTML file of this particular thing, that will be invoked to the personal templates personal app HTML file. Okay, so that will avoid your confusion. So now coming to here, create, and then to create a new any file, just a HTML file. I can readily do that in my Visual Studio Code, but today I'm not going to use that. I am writing in my Notepad. In Notepad, I'm just writing with p tag. Hello, welcome to Dhaksh Tutorials Django. There are many spelling mistakes. Okay, just save it. So to save it, where I have to save, go to your desktop, Dhaksh site, personal app, templates, personal app. Here you have to save it. So to save into the another anything, I'm making it as index.html. So write it in double quotes so that it will be saved in your HTML format. Okay. So let me save it again. Save as. Okay, done. See, you could see index.html here. Now go back to your personal app and write down your views. What you have to write down in your views, because you have created something and that should be there in your view. So in your view, what you do, import this import render. Here you write down the views. What you have to write, definition means defining. Sorry, definition, it's not defining. Index. Index, I'm writing a parameter, I'm giving a parameter request, and then colon, and then return render of, what you have to return, you have to return the request, comma, and here personal app index.html. So what does it mean, save it? So it means that you import, you are defining a function name as index, and we are giving one parameter request. So this request, what it should give, it should return, it should go to the personal app index.html, whatever the data is there, that data it has to collect and it has to return to this particular views. Okay, now close it. And now we have to create URLs also, but we don't have a URL file here, so you have to create it. For that, what you do, you can copy any of your particular thing here and then paste it here. As I copied views, I'll be getting views copy. So just rename it. This is the thing I'm telling you, if you don't have any specific IDE. Okay. And now go and edit here with this Python. So when you, what you have to write here, delete everything and then write down from the same thing which I have done for our previous web app thing. What you have done, the same thing, like import from django.urls. Import path, and also from dot import views. It means that from personal app import views, and URL pattern is equal to, what is the pattern you will be giving, path. What is the path? We'll be giving empty here, empty, and here views.index. It means that in views, go to the index thing. Name equal to index. And just save it. So now we have created templates, we have created a HTML file in that, and we have edited our views as well as URLs. But we have to make the changes in the URLs of Dhaksh site, because this is the root file of our site. So whenever you call, you run, this particular thing will get open, for which you have to edit this the same way how we, what we have done for the previous web application, the same way. Just write down here path, because already include and already there, you no need to worry about that now, because we have already created. So now write down anything. As it's a personal app, I will be writing here personal app only. Personal app, and then include. What you have to include? Personal app URL. So write down personal app dot urls. Save it. So let's close everything and come over here and we'll run the server. We'll check whether it's running perfectly or not. Okay, here there's a dot. So personal app urls.py edit. Okay, it should be comma. Save it. See, as I've applied the changes, it's now running properly. It automatically make the changes. Now open your browser and go to your path. So here you could see personal app. Okay, let me check it. Okay, I did not give slash there. Let's see if it will work or not. Go to your Dhaksh site, urls.py, edit, your slash, and then save. See? Okay, again we'll open it. Control C, run server. Go to your browser. Here you could say personal app. Just write down personal app here. What we have done here, see whatever the changes. Now I will open this in my this thing, Visual Studio Code. It will be easy for me to explain now. The only thing I did not use it previously because to tell you if you don't have that particular thing. So in my personal app, I have created a templates folder. In templates, I have created index.html. Whatever the data I have written here in my index.html, that is represented here. But did I call, what did I do? I did not write this anything in my views or anywhere. I have just written this in my templates and in my views I have called it. But what did I do? Written render request, and this request should go to the personal app index.html. So your views is doing this part. But if you remember in our previous application web app, even if I'll open here and I will go and open web app here, which I have seen in the previous session. So welcome to Dhaksh. In your web app, if you open your, go to your web app and see your views. So we have written in views itself. In views, I have written something and this is what replicated in my browser. But here I did not write in views, but instead what I did, I have written in one of HTML page, and that HTML page I have called here in my views. Okay, and rest is everything is same, that you have created your URL path and you have made changes in your main site URLs also. Okay, I hope you understood this session. We'll be back with another session very soon. And please, if you are liking my videos, please do subscribe to my channel Dhaksh Konga and for all informative sessions, and please do comment for more informative as well as to have interactive sessions. Thank you. Have a nice day.